Hello students, today I want to welcome you to another science lesson for PhD students. And in today's lesson, there are several objectives that we want to cover. One, identify the different types of simple and compound machines. Two, differentiate between load, fulcrum, and effort. And three, identify the three classes of levers and which simple machine is first, second, and third class lever. So remember, you can subscribe for quick access to all the videos that will be posted and all the lesson. So let's go straight into our lesson for today on simple machine. And in today's lesson, we want to get a good idea of what is a simple machine. A simple machine is a machine that uses force to make work easier. It has none or very few moving parts. There are six types. We have the inclined plane, we have the screw, we have the wedge, we have the lever, the wheel and axle, and the pulley. And here's a picture showing the different simple machine. You have an inclined plane, you have the lever, you have the wedge, you have the screw, you have the pulley, and you have the wheel and axle. And simple machine, it's a topic that is very important to our everyday life because it makes work much easier for us. Machines are devices or tools that help to make work easier. A simple machine has few parts: load, fulcrum, and effort. The crowbar, seesaw, scissors, and wheelbarrow are examples of levers. The wheel and axle also makes work easier. Less effort is used to lift a load when more than one pulley is used. Machines, when cleaned and oiled regularly, last longer. The energy used to work simple machines may be supplied by the food we eat. And compound machines, what are compound machines? Compound machines are those that use two or more simple machines to create work. A simple example of a compound machine is a bicycle. It has wheels and axles and a lever in the form of the pedals that make it a compound machine. Then here we have examples of some different compound machines. We have, for instance, a stone axe, which has two parts, a wedge and a lever. We have this machine that is known as a shears, which you can see the levers, the part that you hold. The wedge is a cutting part. Then a wheelbarrow is also an example of a compound machine. It has a wheel and axle and the levers, the handle that you hold the machine. Then here we have a simple machine, a pliers. If you can see, we apply the effort, the part that we hold. The fulcrum is the part that holds the machine together. And the load is whatever this simple machine will hold. Then here's a well-known arm that is always used in PSC. You have the effort, which is a muscle. You have the fulcrum, which joins the arm together. And you have the hand, which is holding the load. And it's this ball that is the load. Then here you have another simple machine. You have the fulcrum here that holds the machine together. The force, and that's the part that we're going to pull on. And the load is the nail that the machine is holding. Here you have the lever that the man is holding, and you have the fulcrum, the part that is holding the lever, and you have the weight, which is a stone, which is the load. We have levers, and levers can be divided into three types. We have a first class lever, second class lever, and a third class lever. So right now you might be looking at this picture and say, what is the difference between the three classes? Well, class one, as you can see, it starts with the effort, then in the center is the fulcrum, and at the end is the load. So class two, you have the effort, then in the center you have the load, and at the end on your right hand side you have the fulcrum. Then a class three lever, you have on the left hand side here, it starts with the fulcrum, in the center you have the effort, and at the end on your right hand side is the load. So looking at these different types of lever, the three types, this will determine and tell you which simple machine is class one, class two, or class three levers. So let's look at this a little closer. So first class lever, a good example, it says in a first class lever, the fulcrum is found between the load and the applied force. And as you can see in the picture, look at it carefully, you see the load, the fulcrum in the center, and you have the applied force. Then a second class lever, it says in a second class lever, the fulcrum is found after or the other side of the load, away from the applied force. And the wheelbarrow here is a perfect example of a second class lever and a third class lever. It says in a third class lever, the fulcrum is found situated before or in front of the applied force. So the arm is a perfect example of a third class lever. Then to continue, here are some examples of classes of lever. So at the bottom, you see class 1, class 2, class 3. Remember, a quick review, class 1, you have the effort. Then in the center, you have the fulcrum. Then at the end, you have the load. Then class 2, you have the effort. In the center, you have the load. And at the end, you have the fulcrum. And in class 3, you have the fulcrum, the effort in the center, and the load at the end. Here are some examples of some machine, and this will tell us which one is which class. So a hammer is a perfect example of a first class lever. As you can see, in the center, you have the fulcrum, then you have the effort, then you have the load at the end. Then a wheelbarrow is a perfect example of a second class, and the arm is a perfect example of a third class lever. A pliers is also an example of first class, a nutcracker, second class, and this next sugar machine is an example of a third class lever. So you can see, and you could identify them by the class, see which one comes based on the load, the effort, and the fulcrum, and that will determine which class of machine you're dealing with. And to continue with simple machine, we want to go over a few questions on simple machine. This one says, which simple machine forms part of the compound machine above at O? Is it A, a gear, B, lever, C, screw, or D, wedge? So O, of course, is the stick part that you're holding, and so O is considered the lever. So the lever is a part of the machine that you hold. So you're going to hold the stone axe, the shears, you're going to hold it with your two hands, to squeeze it, and a wheelbarrow, you're going to hold it on the two arms of the wheelbarrow. Then it says, which simple machine forms part of the compound machine above at X? So if you can see at X in both the stone axe and the shears is a cutting part, and we know the cutting part of a simple machine is known as the wedge. The cutting part at X, of course, will be the wedge. Then we have another example. It says, Huang needs to lift the refrigerator into the back of the truck. What simple machine would he use to make this job easier? And of course, he will use an inclined plane to just light up the refrigerator right into the truck. So you will use less effort because the inclined plane will make the job much easier. And again, a quick review. Machines are devices or tools that help to make work easier. A simple machine has few parts: the load, the fulcrum and effort, the crowbar, seesaw, scissors and wheelbarrow are examples of levers. The wheel and axle also makes work easier. Less effort is used to lift a load when more than one pulley is used. Machines, when cleaned and oiled regularly, last longer. The energy used to work simple machines may be supplied by the food we eat. And again, a quick summary of our topic, simple machines. The inclined plane is a sloping surface. The ramp and playground slide are examples of inclined planes. The wedge is made up of two inclined planes. And a screw is an inclined plane wrapped around a cylinder or post. So students, make sure you get well familiar with the three types of levers. It's very important. And remember, you can subscribe for quick access to all the lessons and videos that will be posted. Share this lesson with a friend or someone that is going to take PSC. And thanks so much for tuning in. A lot more coming soon, so stay tuned.